Hi everyone, this video is going to be about Jedi training at Walt Disney World. First up, please check out my Facebook page at Vacation with the Magic. Shelby Frick with Vacation with the Magic that recently changed. Also check out my blog that will usually have more information about the video. All the information is down below for that. And if you like this video, please give it a thumbs up, comment, subscribe. I am a travel agent, just a little side note, and my specialty is Walt Disney World and Disney Cruise Line. I do discount monitoring, dining reservations, fast pass reservations, and itineraries to save you time so you're not waiting in line. So, Jedi training. Jedi training takes place at Hollywood Studios at Walt Disney World. And this is the biggest thing that anybody ever asks me about. Ever. It's all over Facebook, everything. Everybody wants to know about Jedi training. It is for children 4 years old to 12 years old. It is free with your park admission. And what Jedi training is your child will go through a process. They will get a lightsaber. It's a fake lightsaber, obviously. And they will be trained in the ways of the Force. And then they get to battle some special guests. The special guests do vary. Darth Vader's been there, the Seven Sisters been there, and Darth Maul has been there. So, and Kylo Ren may make a special appearance. So just, it's very exciting, very exciting. Where is Jedi training? Jedi training stage is to the left of Star Tours. Okay, so we're going to start with signing up. Once again, the children must be between 4 years old and 12 years old of age, 4 to 12, 12 max. They have to be with you when you sign up, and you will see people dragging their children through Hollywood Studios as they race to the sign-up location. The sign-up location is to the left. Once you go through the entranceway, it's to the left. It's past Hollywood and Vine, 50s Primetime, and towards Indiana Jones Stunt Spectacular. Registration opens when Hollywood Studio opens. So the kids, once again, have to be with you when you register because they will be asked some questions to make sure that they can follow directions without an adult present. And availability is limited. It is offered on a first-come, first-serve basis. Okay, so tip number one for Jedi training. If you want to do it, and for example, Hollywood Studios opens at 9 a.m., I would be at the park, the front of the entrance, at the turnstiles of the tickets by 8 a.m. And you're gonna think I'm a wackadoo for saying this, but it's so true. Might be 10 minutes off. It might give you a little bit of buffer time, but it gets crazy busy with people wanting to sign up their kids for Jedi training. And I have been there in line, and people don't realize what it is, or people tried the day before and they couldn't get in because they arrived at the park at 9:30. Could it be possible if you arrive at the park at 9:30 and there's a spot opening? Of course you could. But if you are dead set, you have to do this, your children have to do this, then I would get at the park at the turnstiles an hour before park opening. Now, when you go and sign up, they will ask you some questions. Like I said, they will ask your children some questions. And then they will give you a time to return. They will work with fast passes if they can. If it's crazy busy or if you're later, if you come in late to the line, then they might not be able to work with your fast passes. But if you're there early, then they can work with your fast passes. Jedi training currently, this is the end of February, it is taking place from 9:40 to 6:40. So all day long, it's every half hour. The show is 20 minutes long. Tip number two. So with Jedi training, what we tend to do, my son just turned 8. So my children are 8 and 10, and this is always on their must-do list. We have a reservation at park opening at Hollywood and Vine, and my children are past the Disney Junior stage. The last trip, they absolutely hated it. They did not want to get their picture taken with Doc McStuffins, which was fine with me. And I even told them this trip, fine, you don't have to have your picture taken with Doc McStuffins. The reason why I do this is because we have an 8 a.m. reservation for Hollywood and Vine. The park opens at 9 a.m. We get in the park early. younger than everybody else outside. My husband takes the kids, and they get to go sign up for Jedi training before our reservation. I go check us in at Hollywood and Vine, and they say, you know, you can't be seated until your whole party's here. Just let us know when they come back. Perfectly normal thing to do now. So my kids definitely get a spot in Jedi training, and then we go in, we have a breakfast. It's nice. It's wonderful, because by the time we come out for breakfast, usually about 8:50, the line for the sign-up is past Hollywood and Vine and curling up around the main entranceway. So it does get long very, very fast. That's why I said you should come to the, get to the parks an hour before park opening if you do not have the early dining reservation. Now, what happens when you get your return time? Okay, so you go, you get your return time, you go around, you tour the parks, and then you come back to the return location a little bit before your return time, or around your return time. They will give the kids a robe. They will give the kids a name badge, and they will talk to the kids a little bit. And usually they give them like a water bottle, because it's usually, you know, hotter than the surface of the sun. So, and what my tip number three is for this is, if you have more than one adult in your party, one adult takes the kids back at the return time. The other adult goes to Jedi training location, which I said is to the left of Star Tours, and stakes out a spot for pictures and video. Usually what happens is my husband takes the kids back for their return time. I go stake out a spot. Usually the other show is happening right then and there. So I just hang back by Backlot Express, maybe grab a drink or something. And then when that show's over, I scooch my way up. There is no shade. So keep that in mind while you are watching your children do Jedi training and they're so ecstatically happy. There is no shade for the spectators. None whatsoever. Tip number, I forget what number I'm on. So the next tip is that there is a photo pass photographer there. So during the Jedi training, he is taking pictures, lots and lots of pictures, and he has taken some great pictures of my kids. So if you have Memory Maker, this is included in your Memory Maker, which is absolutely fantastic. At the end, he goes to all the parents, he has a little card, hands out all the cards, and then you just, there's a number on the back, you enter the number, you link it to your Memory Maker, easy peasy, done. So the kids return when it's time to do the Jedi training, and they go up, it's very cute, they learn the ways of the Jedi, and they can either battle Darth Vader. Darth Maul has been known to make an appearance. The Seventh Sister has been known to make an appearance. So it all depends on who's there that day. It's usually been Darth Maul, not Darth Maul, oh my gosh, usually it's been Darth Vader and the Seventh Sister. But sometimes, like I said, Darth Maul makes an appearance. This is very popular during May 4th. And during May 4th, they allow adults to do it, which is super duper cool. At least they have in the past. I don't know if this will continue to be a trend. And then they bring out like a third stage area, and then they'll have Darth Maul in that area. So you'll have Darth Vader, the Seventh Sister, and Darth Maul. So cool. Maybe even bring out Kylo Ren once in a while. That is it for info and tips. I hope I helped you somewhat. This, like I said, is very, very popular. I'm going to include some video snippets of my kids doing it so you get an idea of what they go through with the Jedi training process. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you next time.
Join me. It is the only way.
Only way to the dark side. Ready position. Left shoulder. Right shoulder. Stop. Out for the head. Wow, such speed. Saber now.
Stand right here.
I, for one, would love to hear you scream.
I don't think so.
Ready position. Left shoulder. Right shoulder. Stop. Now, touch the head.
Good job. You fight so calmly.